So today we are going to see a quicksort algorithm. Here first we will see what is the quicksort algorithm. So first in quicksort we will take a pivot element. Okay. So in our quicksort algorithm we are going to consider one element called pivot element, and here we are going to always take the pivot element as the first element. Okay. So in every array we are going to sort it, no? So we will take the first element as the pivot element. Okay, for example, how is the working procedure of a pivot, that is a quick sort is, we need to arrange these all elements in a sorted order using a quick sort algorithm. Okay, so here I am taking this element as a pivot element and I am going to compare with this element and going to sort it according to the algorithm. So here after sorting I may get some elements like 7 at this position. And I have to arrange the other elements as it, so that the element 7, this is the pivot element. Okay, so pivot element, the greater than this number, that is the pivot element, what and all values are greater than this pivot element should come at the this side. Okay, so for example, in this values are 15, 9, 10. Here this side, what and all values are smaller than 7, 1, 2, 5. So these are the, so pivot element we are taken, and this element at the left hand side all the elements should be smaller elements, and the right hand side all the elements should be the greater elements. So like this we need to arrange our elements in a order, and again I will partition this elements into a this one as a pivot element, and again I will segregate this. I will do this all the steps till I get the sorted array. Okay, so this is the procedure of a sorting quick sorting algorithm. So we will go into a problem. So now we shall see the working principle of the quick sort algorithm. So here in this we are going to follow the algorithm. This is the algorithm of the quick sort. So here in the first condition what they have said, starting element should be taken as the pivot element. So I am going to take this 7 as the pivot element. So starting element 7. So this element will be the pivot element. And again the second point is starting element as start. So here I am going to take this element as a start. Okay. Then ending element as the end. So what is the end element here? This is the 9th place. So this is the end element. So I have taken it according to the algorithm. This algorithm only step by step we are going to do for the quick sort algorithm. Okay. So here we are going to check the condition. So this loop only we are going to keep on going through the algorithm. Okay. So first condition we need to check the start element. So we are at the position start and start less than end. So start less than end means it is not the value. Okay. It is the position they are mentioning. Here this point and this point, here both the things are mentioning the position, not the value. Okay, so you just need to remember that the start is less than end means it is not the values. Okay, start less than end means it is the position. Okay, so next we can go into a problem. So here start is less than end. So start value is at 0 position and the end value is at the 8th position. So 0 is less than 8, position only we need to take. So this condition is true, so that I am going to inside this loop. Okay, so increment the start value until element at position start less than or equal to pivot. Okay, so here start value is what? Start value is 7. Okay, 7 less than or equal to pivot. What is the pivot element? Same element, so 7. So if this condition is true means we need to increment the position of start. Okay, one position we need to increment. So I am increment the position of the, so this condition is true. So I am going to increment the start position. So start position will be now here. Okay, now start is here. So next again I have to check the same condition. Okay, so now I am going to take the pivot element. Okay, start is less than end, so this condition, so inside this loop I am coming. So I am taking start value is 6. less than or equal to pivot element. Pivot element is 7. So 6 is less than or equal to 7. So this condition is true. So I am going to increment the start. So increment start value until element at the position. So again start value will be incremented by 1 position. Okay. So now start will be here. So again I am going to check the condition. Start value is less than or equal to pivot. So start value is 10. Less than or equal to pivot value is 7. So is this condition true? No. This condition is failed. Because 10 is the greater value than 7. So this condition is failed. So if the condition is failed means we need to leave the start position at this position itself. Okay. So start position is pointing at 10. So next we are going to the end element. So now I am going to check this condition. Okay. Keep decrementing end value until the element at the position end must be greater than pivot. So end value is 7 greater than pivot value. Pivot value is 7. So here they are saying if this both the conditions are true means we need to decrement the one position. But here at this place the both the elements are not, they did not say the condition as greater than or equal to. They have said the condition as 7 greater than 7. No, this condition is false. So if this condition is false means what you have to do? If start is less than end. So after sorting the array, the positions of the 10 and 7 would have been changed according to this condition. If start is less than end, then we have to swap the start and end position. So we have swapped the both the positions. Okay. So now here will be the start position and here will be the end position. Again, we need to check the conditions. Okay. So here, what is the condition? Start less than end. So start value, start position is less than end position. So again, we need to check these conditions. So start less than or equal to pivot. So start value is now 7. Less than or equal to pivot value is 7. So is this condition true means what you have to do? We need to increment the start position. So now start position will be pointing to 5. Okay. Now start position is at 5. Then again what we have to do, again next condition. Start is less than or equal to pivot. Start value is now 5. Less than or equal to 7. So again this condition is true. So again I have to increment the start position. Now start position will be incremented by 1. So start position will be here. So again I am going to check the condition. 9 less than or equal to pivot element 7. So this condition is false because 9 is greater than 7. So now I will stop the position of 7. So now I am going to the end position. So again I am going to check the condition. End is greater than pivot. End value is what? 10. Greater than pivot. So end is greater than pivot. Yes, this condition is true. So if this condition is true means what you have to do? Keep decrementing end value until the element at the position. So again I am going to decrement this end position. Okay, so now end will be here. Okay, so again we are going to check the condition for this. So end is 15 greater than pivot value 7. This condition is true. Again, I am going to decrement the value of end. So now end will be here. So now I am going to check this element. End is 1 greater than pivot value 7. So again, this condition is false. 1 is greater than 7 means this condition is false. So I am not going to increment this. Okay. So now the position of start is at 9 and end is at 1. So at this condition what you have to do, we have to check this condition. If start is less than end, these are the positions. As I said in beginning, start and end are not values, they are both are positions of that value. Okay, start position value is 1 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 and 8. The positions only they are saying here. Okay, start is less than end. Start position is 4, less than end position is 6. So this condition is true. So I am going to swap these two values. Okay, start and end value are going to be swapped. So I will write this array now. So now the array will be like, these two positions are being swapped. Okay, so after swapping, this will be 1, 2, 9, 15 and 10. So these are the array. Now the array will be like this after swapping. So after swapping these two values, the array was like this. Okay, so 10 was here and 7 was, both were swapped. The next time we are swapping, the elements will be in this order. Okay, so same point, same position we need to be pointing. So now the start value will be here, okay, at the position of 4. So again end value will be here. Okay, start will be here and end will be here after swapping. So again we need to check the condition. Start is less than end. Yes, this condition is true. So again I am going to enter into this loop. Okay, now start is less than or equal to pivot. Start value is 1, less than or equal to pivot. Yes, this condition is true. So if this condition is true, I am going to increment the position of start by 1. So now start will be here, incremented 1 position. Again I am going to check the condition. 2 is less than or equal to 7. Again this condition is true. So what I am going to do, I am going to increment the position of 2. So now 2 will be pointing to here. That pointer start will be pointing to 9. Okay, now I am going to check the condition. 9 is less than or equal to 7. Okay, so this condition is false. Okay, so I cannot do any increment. So next step, what you have to do, I have to check this condition. Okay, now end value is 9 greater than pivot. Pivot value is 7. Yes, this condition is true. So if this condition is true, what you have to do, we are decrementing this side. Okay, now end position will be decremented 1 step. So end will be decremented 1 step. So again I am going to check the condition. 2 is greater than 7. Is this condition true? No, this condition is failed. So I am not going to do the swap operation. So always what I will do, we always check the, we after completing these two steps, what I will do, we will go to this process and we will swap the two elements. Okay, we will go to this process, start is less than end and we will swap. But here that we are not going to do, because start is being preceded 1 step higher. Okay, start is not at the before of end. Okay, so we are not going to follow that process. So now we are going to do the next step. Okay, so now listen, after this conditions, okay, I said in this array we have seen that end position is here and the start position is preceded by 1. So now I have written this condition. Okay, I have written the array like this. So if start is greater than end, means I have to follow this swap of end comma pivot. So that condition only I have did here, you don't confuse. See, listen, so here I have done the swap of end value and 7. So these two values have been swapped. Okay, so that element only I have written here. Okay, I have swapped these two elements and written into the array. So now we have to check one condition. Okay, pivot element has been shifted. Okay, we have come to this position. So here you read this, finally end position in is the pivot position, so that elements left to pivot are less and then pivot value, and element right to the pivot are greater than pivot. So here what they are coming to say is, pivot value was at the beginning was 7, so till this position 7. So all the three steps, 7 was here, pivot value was here. So when this condition is satisfied, we need to check this. So now 7 is here, at the left of 7 all the elements are being less than 7 or equal to 7. And the right elements, all the elements are greater than 7. So this is the conditions we are being satisfied. So this is the process we are going to follow until we get a array of ascending order array sorted, okay, using quick sort. So now again what we have going to follow is we are going to partition these elements using this method itself, and these elements again using this method. So using these conditions we are going to sort this and sort this. So now what I will take, I will take this 2 as the pivot value and the start value, and the end will be here. Again I am going to sort this array. Again I am going to partition and sort this array. So this method we will also call as partition method. Okay, we will call this as sorting, quick sorting algorithm or partition method. So this is the way we are going to follow our quick sort algorithm. So you can solve this by yourself. Now we can see the algorithm. This is the algorithm. So we are going to write the program for this quick sort. So the program is here. We will see the algorithm. We will see the part, what are the steps we are done inside this, and we are going to write the program for this. Okay, so first of all what we did, always we will take one partition set. Okay, this is the lower bound side and this is the upper bound side, we will say. Okay, because at this finally we will get all the lower bound values this side and upper bound values this side. So we are going to write this. Now I am writing the program partition. This is an array. Okay, this is an array. So I am writing A of lower bound comma upper bound. Okay, lower bound and upper bound values. So inside this what we have done, we have taken a pivot is equal to pivot value we are taken, and pivot value will be the lower bound first element, A of lower bound. Okay, so A of lower bound value. Okay, now next we are going to write the start position will be placed at the lower bound. Okay, lower bound means nothing but first. Okay, first element lower bound, last element upper bound. We, as we mentioned, as start and end, here I am writing as start is equal to lower bound. Next I am going to write the next step, end is equal to upper bound. So end value will be the upper bound I am mentioning. Okay, now I am going to write a while loop. What are all steps we have done as an algorithm, we are going to write it as an coding. Okay, so here I am giving the condition. So I will write one condition here, so that only I gave this braces. Okay, first we will complete this inner loop, then we can write the outer loop. So while A of start, okay, so we checked with the pivot value, right, the condition, if A of start is less than or equal to pivot. So if this condition is there, what we'll do, if the A of start value is less than or pivot value, what we did, we incremented the start position one by one. So that is the thing we are going to write, start of plus plus. Okay, so I am closing this loop. Again next condition what we did, we went to end. Okay, we again decremented one by one. If the pivot value is greater than, that is the end value is greater than the pivot value, means we decremented one by one. So that condition we are going to write, while A of end is greater than pivot value, what we wrote, we decremented one by one. If the A of end value is greater than the pivot value, that is 10 is greater than 7, means what we did, we decremented one by one. So that is the condition I am going to write here, end minus minus. Okay, and I am closing the loop. Again this is not only the two conditions we checked, again one condition we checked, what condition was that, while start is greater than, that is start is less than end. Okay, if the start is less than end only, we need to follow this steps. Here we seen, right, if the start is less than end only, we are going to follow these two steps. Okay, This only we are written as coding. Okay, so here, otherwise what I will do, if this is less than only, I am going to follow these two loops. Otherwise, if another one condition is here, start is less than end. If start is less than end means after completing these two steps, what we did, we swapped start and end. Okay, that condition I am going to write. Swap A of start comma A of end. Okay, so these are the two conditions. Okay, this condition will be followed. Start is less than end means we have to follow these three steps. A of start must be less than pivot means increment start plus plus. Then while of A of end is greater than pivot means we have to end minus minus. After completing these two steps of this array, we need to do this condition. If start is less than end, we have to swap the two conditions. Okay, so start comma end will be swapped. So I am going to close this loop. Suppose if that condition is not true means, if this condition, that is start less than end condition, is failed. So here this condition was failed, right? What we did, we swapped A of lower bound. What is the lower bound value? That is end. Okay, that value with the lower bound is A of end. We swapped A of lower bound value with the A of end. Then we return end. So this is the condition we followed at the final. Okay, so this is the simple algorithm for partitioning. So next we will just write the conditions for this. Okay, so here I will write the, so what and all steps we are going to do it later, that we are writing here. I have written in this algorithm itself. See, after this step what you are doing, do the same process for the two partitions, this partition and this partition. We are going to follow this step. What they have said is low to pivot minus 1. Low to pivot minus 1 means nothing but, so here we, here is the 7. Okay, so before this value I am going to decrement. This side we all are the decremented value, and 7 plus 1. So we are going to check these conditions, that only they have written here. Okay, so anyway we will write that code. Okay, quick sort. So here after writing this only we have to write that. So first we need to understand the partition, so I have written that first. Okay, so here quick sort A comma lower bound comma upper bound. So lower bound, upper bound array and all, you know. So now I am going to check the condition. If lower bound is less than upper bound, so if this condition is true, okay, then we have to, what we did here after swapping off, finally if start is greater than end means what we did, we swapped the lower bound and upper bound values. Okay, that is the swapping of 2 and 7 we did. Okay, so we returned the end value. Why you are returning end value is, here we need the, this is the end value, so that I am returning this end value. So we are going to write this algorithm, so only I have written the end value. So now end value is 7. Okay, so I will take it as location for understanding. I will take this end value as location. So location is equal to, that is this 7 is equal to partition of, again I am going to partition this two arrays separately, no? So A of lower bound comma location minus 1, that is array of lower bound location minus 1. Location minus 1 means this value, location minus 1. So that only I have written here. Okay, so here we will first write the arrays what and all inside, array lower bound and upper bound. Okay, inside this loop I will write that quick sort A comma lower bound comma location minus 1. Okay, so here I have, after this location is 7, into partition of array lower bound values and upper bound values. Quick sort, we are going to do A of lower bound values are this side. So location minus 1, location minus 1. So again I am going to do the partition operation for that. So next, quick sort a comma location plus 1 comma upper bound. So this meaning is array location plus 1, location plus 1 means this, and upper bound. So that is the quick sort. So this is the working procedure and the program for our quick sort. And here we need to see one condition. Okay, so for our quick sort, the best case will be O of n square. Okay, so that is the thing we have said. Thank you.